how are we doing today? Today's video is going to be a V-Talk video. If you haven't seen my videos talking about periods, how to clean yourself, how to catch your menstrual blood and menstruation and all that stuff, then you can check out those two videos. I'll have those linked in the card section here. We're gonna continue in that same vein, and I'm gonna be talking all about the disgusting bumps that are on your vagina when you get waxed or shave. Bumps, hair bumps, ingrowns, dark spots, problem areas when you get waxed, shave, whatever. But particularly for girls who get waxed, because I get waxed, so this is particularly for you. If you guys wanna know more about waxing, you wanna know why I like to wax, if you wanna know why I think waxing is better than shaving, and where I get waxed, and how I get waxed, and all the body parts that I get waxed, and talking all about those issues and that whole thing, I have a video on that already. So you guys can go check that out. It's in the card section up here. I am going to be talking a little bit about waxing in this video, but not so much because I just want to focus on the aftercare of waxing and how to prevent any problems that you might have with it. We want to prevent ingrowns, we want to prevent bumps, we want to prevent all these problems because it helps for our waxing experience to be more comfortable. Also, you won't have to get your ingrowns plucked out by the wax lady when you go, and it just makes for an overall more healthy and happy experience. Nobody wants to have dark spots. Nobody wants to have an ugly Virginia, okay? We want Virginia to be pretty, no matter what. I mean, it doesn't matter who's going down there and who's seeing it because it's your body, but if you can make it look better, why not make it look better? Why not give her the opportunity to have her shine? You know what I'm saying? So first of all, I do get waxed. I get Brazilian waxes. I also get my stomach waxed. I get my underarms waxed. I get my leg, my full legs waxed, and my full butt waxed, all up in the crack, all up in the creases, all up in the crevices. I get literally everything waxed. I've tried all the types of waxing. I've tried sugaring. I've tried shaving, I've tried Nair, I've tried epilating, I've tried everything but laser hair removal, and I'm extremely afraid of laser hair removal. I don't know why, but I haven't gotten to that point yet. So waxing is like the next best thing for me. One thing I noticed when I switched over from shaving to waxing is that I had a little bit of trouble with ingrowns and dark spots. And if you guys don't know, my skin is prone to hyperpigmentation, not just on my face, but on my body as well. So I tend to have breakouts around my chest area, around the sensitive parts on my legs, so like my upper thigh area. I also get them on my booty and in my bikini area as well. I get a lot of dark spots from hair bumps and things of that nature. Hair bumps are normal. They are normal, okay? So don't feel like you're a monster. If you have hair bumps, dark spots, all that stuff, you're normal, okay? That's a normal thing. It happens. Especially with darker skinned women, I feel like we get them more often. And if we don't get them more often, they at least look a little bit worse because our skin has more melanin. And when we have scars or any type of irritation, our skin like makes more melanin in that spot and creates a dark spot. So, you know, melanin is great and everything, and I love my melanin. However, my melanin sometimes works against me. So I try to minimize those problems as much as possible so that I don't have so many body dark spots, because the last thing you want to do is get waxed and have smooth skin and have a smooth body and you're ready to party. You go out on the beach in your bikini and you have dark spots. The first way that I would recommend to get rid of dark spots, exfoliating is key. It'll also help prevent ingrowns. Ingrowns come when your hair is getting trapped underneath your skin. The best way to get rid of those ingrowns and minimize the amount of dark spots from those ingrowns is to make sure you're exfoliating. And by exfoliation, I mean scrubbing. You want to scrub your body using a not too harsh, but abrasive scrub, something that's gonna get rid of the dead skin. You wanna do this before and after. I try not to do it directly after because your skin's a little bit more sensitive after you get waxed, but you do wanna make sure that you are exfoliating before you get waxed, for sure. Like the week before I get waxed, I exfoliate like almost every night or every other night. I try to make sure that I get all the dead skin off as much as possible, because if not, then, you know, it's going to be hard. Number one, it's going to be harder for your hair to come up because you have all this dead skin and dry skin. But also it creates ingrowns after you get waxed as well. I try to use my hands to wash my body. I try not to use any loofahs. I try not to use towels because those hold bacteria and you don't want to be putting bacteria into your skin, especially when your pores are open. This will cause hair bumps and things like that as well, especially in your sensitive area, like your vagina, and around that area, that if you do get that area waxed, you want to be careful. I use unscented or all natural soaps. So I use Dr. Bronner's soap. You guys know I love Dr. Bronner's. I use that on that area. I use that all over my body to prevent bumps and breakouts. The scrub that I really, really love the most is the Soap and Glory body scrub. You guys know I love Soap and Glory. I've already talked about Soap and Glory a million times, but I love their scrubs. The scrubs are very nice. They're not too harsh. They don't hurt my skin or irritate me. And they smell really good. I also love the European Wax Center's body scrubs as well. They changed the formula, I think, on their scrub. So I don't know. I haven't tried it since then. But I do like their scrubs too. They're $20 each. So every time I go get waxed, right before, like literally before, because I like to take a shower before I go get waxed, because I mean, I don't want to be spreading my cheeks and stuff and it's like dirty down there and it stinks. That's nasty. So I try to take a shower right before I go to my wax appointments. And every time I take a shower, I will scrub my body. Before you get waxed, they're going to wipe you down anyway. So you don't need to have any lotions or anything that's not going to help your hair to come up. Exfoliating under your arms and getting waxed helps to prevent the darkness under your arms too. My underarms are lightening up a lot. Our bikini areas tend to be darker anyways. So, I mean, whatever can help that darkness. I mean, obviously, if you don't care about how it looks down there, then girl, go ahead, do what you gotta do. I like for my skin to be one color for the most part. I mean, hey, why not? She wanna be cute too. You know, if you exfoliate, it makes it a lot less painful. It actually helps with the pain level by like 25%. All right, so the next tip that I have for you guys is aloe vera gel. This is the aloe vera gel that I use, but you can get aloe vera straight from the plant. I got this from the grocery store. If you are going to be using aloe vera, I would always suggest that you use it straight from the plant or as close to straight from the plant as possible if it is bottled. I use it all over the places that I get waxed, and y'all, I'm telling you, this is probably the best solution I've tried for getting rid of dark spots. I mean, my dark spots are still there, but they're definitely lightening up, and it prevents new dark spots when you get ingrowns or hair bumps or anything like that. So because it's all natural, it comes straight from the plant, you can use this in your bikini area around your vagina. Don't put it in your vagina. Don't put anything in your vagina. I also feel like this is really good for people who have sensitivities and things like that, because it does help with soothing. It has soothing properties. This will definitely soothe those areas. And in the summertime, it feels really good because it's like cooling. I know the place that I go to uses an ingrown hair serum and a lotion after they do your waxing and all that stuff. They typically don't put anything on the vagina area but the serum, just because your vagina area creates moisture by itself, so you don't really need to add to it. Right after you shower, make sure you put on the aloe vera gel. It'll help to soothe the area and keep it from breaking out, having any problems. So yeah, make sure you do that. Another product that you can use, I wouldn't really suggest using this on your bikini area because I don't know if that's safe, but I do use this on my legs and my body sometimes. This is the acne.org AHA cream. Acne.org products are meant for the face and for sensitive areas like your neck, your chest, your back, areas where you do break out. But that's why I try to use Dr. Bronner's soap and all natural ingredients on my body, because I know my body is just as sensitive as my face. I've used this before on my legs. Using glycolic acid on your body definitely doesn't hurt. I would try to mix it with something though. Maybe mix it with the aloe vera gel. I don't know. But you can use this. I have used this on my body and it has worked. Another way to get rid of ingrowns and prevent ingrowns is to use wipes. These wipes are by the European Wax Center. You can only get this at the European Wax Center. I don't know if you can order these or purchase these anywhere else, but they're basically just like wipes like this. I actually cut them in half, and I don't know, I like these wipes. These wipes have worked really well for me to prevent bumps and ingrowns. I would recommend using something like that, or using like all natural wipes, any type of wipe that you use in that area when you go to the bathroom. In the summertime especially, you're gonna get hot, warm, hot areas grow bacteria, right? So if you have bacteria in that area where you've been sweating and things like that, you are more likely to get breakouts and bumps, which will cause more dark spots, and it will cause your bikini area to be not so cute. Sometimes your thighs rub together and get hot throughout the day. So you just wanna make sure that you're keeping that area cool and dry, not sweaty and moist. You know what I'm saying? I'm more prone to getting hair bumps in the summertime because of the heat, because I'm sweating. And if you tend to wear leggings or tight shorts, really tight underwear, I would not suggest compression leggings and shorts, workout tights. Just be careful, okay? You want your area to air out. Try to wear some skirts and some thin panties, some thin cotton panties. Let your boo breathe, okay? Let her breathe. Sleeping with no underwear. Just don't want to have any extraness going on down there, okay? If you want to get your ingrowns out and you have dark spots from ingrowns, the best way to do it is to hop in the shower, really, really hot, steamy shower. And then after you get out, your pores are open, so you'll be able to easily squeeze out those hairs and get them with a tweezer. Get some alcohol and clean your tweezers as much as possible and get those ingrowns out. But you wanna give them time. Like, don't irritate yourself. Don't irritate them by picking at them or touching them a lot or scratching it. That will make more dark spots. So just use the aloe vera gel. It'll help to prevent itchiness and dryness and things like that. That's pretty much all, I think. Be sure to give me more suggestions for these types of videos, these VTalk videos, if you guys want to know more about how to take care of your vagina or body parts that women have that we never talk about, and it's like taboo to talk about it, and you think you're weird because something's wrong with you because nobody else talks about it and you feel like you're the only one. You are not alone. All of your body confidence issues, I'm here to help you make your life better. If you guys have any suggestions for videos in the future, please let me know and I will do them for you. Oh, also, before I go, this makeup look, I did a tutorial on it. So if you guys wanna check that out, it is already on my channel. It should be already on my channel. If it's not on my channel, it'll be up next. If you guys would like to know where this necklace is Be Happy Live Pink. Be sure to check them out. I have a coupon code in the description box. This top is from ASOS, but I got it like a year ago, so they don't have it anymore. I don't know, am I saying enough? I think that's all I have to say. I will talk to you guys in my next video. All right, I'm done. Peace out.